Our top story at 6, engineers are trying to figure out how to clear a massive rock slide that is blocking the only road in and out of one Scotts Valley neighborhood. This is, what happened yesterday, the aftermath of what happened yesterday. A 200-foot-long pile of rock and debris that came crashing down. Now comes the daunting task of figuring out how to clear a 30-foot-deep pile of debris that is covering the roadway. Today, engineers say it won't be easy, it won't be quick, and they say with more rain on the way, it could get even uglier. Action News reporter Phil Gomez is live at the scene with tonight's top story.
Well, Aaron, as you can see, it's raining right now, and this is one of the biggest fears because more rain can just mean that this hillside will become even more unstable. There's no quick fix to removing this mess. Work crews are waiting for a geologist report to estimate how long it will take to remove all these rocks, but residents are digging in, expecting to be cut off for a while.
This is one of the larger slides we've seen in the county. It just slid down off the road. Like an avalanche.
A 200 to 300-foot sandstone avalanche covered Nelson Road in Scotts Valley, and neighbors are worried more could come crashing down.
This is a done deal, and, you know, it's probably not finished, but it's, you know, this has happened. We just have to worry about other areas.
Before any of this rock slide is removed or any work done on it, the Public Works Department has to map out the scope of it.
We got projected rain coming in the next, through the end of the week. So it could move more if the rain gets up there and saturates the upper level. So we want to hold off, let it stabilize, and we're going to look at how we can address, you know, access for the folks up above.
There are also plans for a temporary access road, something that Peggy Whedon is concerned about because neighborhood traffic would run right onto her property.
I'm more than happy to have people walking through my property to get out. I'm a little nervous about proposed driving through my property because my hillside is very unstable, and I'm afraid that the vibration from cars, a lot of cars coming through, would just undo it.
The sheriff's office sent in all-terrain vehicles to check on folks stuck here. A command post was also set up for emergencies.
Should anybody back there have any challenge medically, have any challenge with a new slide event, or just in and out access to provisions, we want to provide that for the community.
Despite the rock slide, spirits are good in the isolated community. Some homeowners have found creative ways to gain access to their property.
A little extra exercise. That's about
it. Good workout.
Yeah, so, you know, we both come home late at night from work, and so we got this ladder set up to get up to the base of the driveway, and then it's about a 3/10 of a mile walk to get to the house. So it's a long driveway, long, steep driveway.
Now, neighbors did meet with work crews in the Public Works Department a couple of hours ago. That's where they were told that the two emergency access roads are being worked on and that a geologist will be out again tomorrow to assess the area. And one thing and one big problem they have is they're going to have to find a place where they're going to be able to dump all of that rubble. Aaron, back
exactly.
To you in the studio.
Lots of logistical issues to deal with. Thank you, Phil. And just in case you want to know, the largest slide to hit Santa Cruz County was the deadly Love Creek mudslide that was in Ben Lomond back in 1982. At least 10 people were killed in that disaster.